Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Alhamdulillah. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Assalatu wassalamu ala rasulil amin wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajmain. Amma ba'd. I am indeed humble in the huge gathering of my brothers and sisters here, and I ask the Almighty to grant us the ability to learn and to implement what we have learned. Aisha Abla binti Abdul Rahim, going to speak a few words on the topic upbringing your children. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has created us and He has given us some responsibilities. A'udhu billahi minash shaitanir rajim. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم يا أيها الذين آمنوا قوا أنفسكم وأهليكم نارا. Who believes, protect yourself and your family from the hellfire. Perhaps your parents may need a reminder or a tapping. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم إنما أموالكم وأولادكم فتنة. Indeed, your wealth and your children are a test from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. On the day of judgment, we can't step forward unless and until we answer the questions. Parenting, in Arabic we call it as ta'rif. It is the process of taking care of a child from a dependent child to an independent adult. The foundation of a child should be in an Islamic way, like reading Quran, reciting Quran, knowing the Hadith, knowing the Sunnah, etc., etc. Upbringing your children should be balanced between encouragement and instructions, warning. You know who are orphans? Orphans are the ones who don't have their parents. But nowadays, a child is not an orphan but an orphan. Did you hear that? A child is not an orphan but an orphan. This actually means that the dad is busy with his side job. He may be a doctor, he may be an engineer, he may be a lecturer. Mashallah, it's good. Meanwhile, he has to spend time with his children, spend time with his spouse. He has to talk to them. You know, whenever you talk to them, you smile at them, you develop correct feeling. You develop connection. Take an active role in guiding your child. Don't upbring them in an evil thing like television. Nowadays, the filthy homosexuality is even shown in the television. A child mimics when it is young. The way we treat our spouse, our children, they are going to treat the same way. A girl, when she gets matured, that's the age where she uproots feeling to the opposite gender. That's the time where her parents, especially mother, should be with her. Never neglect your child. When a child becomes teenager, they become independent. When they become independent, they no longer listen to you. Talk to them. Talk to them before the doors of communication gets closed. There's a hadith that says that it is a sufficient sin for a man who doesn't spend enough money for his children. There's one more hadith that says that fear Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and treat your child equally, fairly. Parents should make sure that tomorrow your child becomes the true inheritance of Islam. According to the Islamic tradition, the best gift that the parents can give to their child is becoming the training to become a responsible Muslim adult, fulfilling the rights of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and others. Ya Allah, give us the unexpected, undeserved gift from our spouse and our children, which makes us so happy that we want to cry. There is one more hadith that says that a man will be raised in status in paradise and he will say, how did I get this? Where did this come from? And the angels will reply, your child praying for forgiveness for you. Did you hear that? Your child praying for forgiveness for you. Mashallah, they are the lucky ones. Now, if we make sure that our child leads an Islamic life, then it is going to benefit us. There's a hadith that says that the three beneficial things a man will take even after his death, and one of those is waladun salihan yad'u lahu. His child praying for forgiveness for you. Mashallah. May Allah grant us the abundant khair in this dunya and akhirah. May Allah protect us from the hellfire. رَبَّنَا آتِنَا فِي الدُّنْيَا حَسَنَةً وَفِي الْآخِرَةِ حَسَنَةً وَقِنَا عَذَابَ النَّارِ رَبِّ اجْعَل لِّي مُقِيمَ الصَّلَاةِ وَمِن ذُرِّيَّتِي رَبَّنَا تَقَبَّلْ دُعَاءِ رَبِّ اغْفِرْ لِي وَلِوَالِدَيَّ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ يَوْمَ يَقُومُ الْحِسَابُ. Now I would like to end my speech. وَأَخِرْ دَعْوَانَا أَنِ الْحَمْدُ لِلَّهِ رَبِّ الْعَالَمِينَ and hope our child leads the Islamic life. Inshallah. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.